Europe's oldest dental school has survived 123 years and two world wars in Leicester Square. Like the windmill, it never closed. But for the Royal's 250 students and 95,000 patients, university spending cuts are proving more of a threat than the Blitz. After the last war, the dental hospital was linked with St George's Hospital, which has moved from Hyde Park Corner to a brand new building at Tooting. A reunion costing £9 million was planned. A merger with Guy's Hospital Dental School is the cheaper alternative.
The merger that's being proposed with Guy's isn't really a true merger. It's proposed that Guy's perhaps take 20 of our students and some of our staff. Now, this school is a very living organism, and to divide it up like that, it will destroy many of the things that we think are important. Sentiment doesn't play any very large part in my thinking. In undergraduate teaching, in postgraduate teaching, in research into dental problems, I think we are leaders in this country. And that is not something that can readily be transplanted to another hospital in the form that is proposed by the university.
Nevertheless, a majority of dental deans and voting academics in the University of London are ready to ditch the Royal. The Royal has the backing of the area and regional health authorities for Tooting, who are demanding a share of London's specialist dental facilities, four MPs and a growing army of supporters. Despite today's decision, the lobbying will continue until the University Court issues a final verdict next month. David Bellin at the Royal Dental Hospital in Leicester Square for Thames News.